We have seen how to distribute keys if Eve has a noisy version of the bits that Alice sends to Bob. Of course, you might be asking, what if Bob also only has a noisy version of these bits? In other words, he does not always receive the bit, but he receives a bit with an error. So there's some probability that the bits are different. Is it still possible to distribute keys in this scenario? Let's have a look at our protocol. Alice chooses random bits and she sends them to Bob. Previously, we were sure that whatever Alice sends is exactly what Bob receives. This meant that if they later computed KA and KB by applying the extractor function, they would have obtained the same key. Now, XA is most likely not equal to XB. In fact, if we have a small error on each bit, the probability that the raw key, XA, will be the same as XB is very small if N is large. This means that it is actually extremely unlikely that KA is equal to KB, and hence our protocol is no longer correct. To have a look how to fix this, let's first try and model this noise more carefully. In key distribution protocols, and this will also be the case for quantum key distribution, we model noise on the channel from Alice to Bob by a bit flip operation. This means that if Alice sends a bit X to Bob, you can imagine that the bit gets XORed with another bit, which here I will call S. S takes the value 1 with a probability P error. So what Bob receives is not X, but X plus S mod 2. We can also write this noise in another way, which is called the binary symmetric channel. What I have written here in the corner is really just the same as what I've written up there when I XORed with the bit S. One way to think about what XORing with the bit S does is that if the initial input bit X is 0, then with the probability 1 minus P error, we will stay 0. If the input is 1, with probability 1 minus P error, it will stay 1. However, if with some small probability, namely the probability of an error, the probability that S is 1, we will flip the bit and we will get the other outcome. So if I had 0 before, I have 1 afterwards, and if I had 1 before, I get 0 afterwards. This channel is called binary because the input and output are bits. It is called symmetric because the errors are the same no matter whether I start with a 0 or a 1. So how can we fix our protocol to deal with such noise? It's clear that we need some form of error correction. So we will change our protocol by adding an extra step. Alice still chooses random bits and sends them to Bob, but now she will send some extra information, some error correcting information C to Bob. These are just classical bits, in which she will send them over the blue classical channel, which has no noise, but Eve has full access to that channel. Of course, having full access, she can also get the error correcting information C. And this error correcting information might help her in her guess for X. This means that the min entropy that we want to consider is now the min entropy of X, given C and E. To deal with this, we apply our usual trick. Namely, we know that the register C can only help so much, or more precisely, this min entropy is never smaller than the min entropy of x given E minus log of the size of C. So this here is exactly the number of bits of error correcting information that Alice sends. As you might imagine, how much error correcting information we need to send depends crucially on the probability of error. So this here, the number of bits that Alice needs to send will be some function of the probability of error. The remainder of this week will be lectured by David Elkos, who is an expert in error correction in key distribution systems. In particular, in quantum key distribution systems, because the techniques that we will use here are precisely the same as in quantum key distribution. My final remark for you this week is just a pointer to the literature. You may have been wondering whether it is only possible to produce key here if the probability of error for Eve is actually larger than the probability of error for Bob. In the sense that we could maybe only produce key if Bob has an advantage over Eve, in the sense that his source of bits is less noisy. It turns out that this is actually not the case. And there's a very beautiful technique called advantage distillation, where Alice and Bob can use the fact that they can communicate classically to bring themselves as an advantage over Eve. I will not discuss this here, but you can find pointers in the lecture notes.